Hey, we're back. It is a new year. We are back for more punishment. Level 9 characters, and we're taking on the Division right from the beginning, like we said. This is another episode of Let's Play the Division from the beginning. No characters or equipment from any other loadouts. I am your host, Mighty Mr. Mustache, the mightiest mustache in the universe, and I am back with Clan Leader James Delhantel Majeros.
What's up?
And Justin Malk, Maven 11 Reyes.
Hey, what's up?
And we're going to take on the next mission, which I believe is Broadway Emporium.
Yep.
All right. Let's get on the move and check it out. We know that survival has dropped over the holidays. It was a lot of fun. It's an interesting play. It's an interesting new game
Still
mode.
Still haven't played
it. No?
Yep.
Nope.
Still haven't played it either.
Active echo beacon detected.
Maybe we'll try it out and do a video if that'll be something interesting.
Wait, what?
Active echo beacon.
James, why did you split the party? You never
Shut
split
up.
The party.
And 1.6, patch 1.6, and a new DLC called Last Stand is on the way and in the works.
Last Stand.
Yeah.
So what's that, just like wave-based survival?
I don't know. It's supposed to be something along those lines, and I'm not sure. No one's learned too much about what Last Stand will be. It's going to be called Last Stand.
For this game.
And some data mining has been done to indicate that 1.6 will include a PvP dedicated arena. Where'd all those guys go? They seem to have vanished.
I exploded them.
yeah, it will include a dedicated PvP arena. Data mining has shown that that is potentially in the code.
Nice.
At the same time, there is talk that Last Stand may be in Central Park.
That'll be cool.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
There seems to be some spaces on the map dedicated to new things from people who have data mined the code, who have a lot more patience and knowledge about computers than any of us do.
Why am I loading?
Are you loading into a new zone?
It just brought me out of that and then into a loading screen. That was weird.
Oh.
But...
Well, the conversations have been back and forth, the heated discussions, all kinds of people screaming that a dedicated PvP arena would empty out the dark zone and ruin PvP in the game, and I don't know. If nobody wants to play the dark zone because they have an option, doesn't that mean that the dark zone kind of sucked?
Oh, this fucking mission.
Yep.
Broadway. Where are you guys?
They're coming towards you.
Oh, that's what happened.
What happened?
He basically boosted all the way over there, man.
Oh, weird. Glitch is in a game.
Like you were
what?
Here, and then whoop, you were right there.
Glitch is in a game, like the Division. Oh no, I'm so shocked.
Guys, there's a lot of cleaners in here.
Okay. We won't make any noise until we start shooting them. Ouch, I seem to be on fire. Holy crap, that hurt.
I seem to be on fire. How terribly inconvenient for you.
Yeah, good thing I heal fast. I did a lot more damage than I'm used to it doing. Okay. Oh, I remember. This is where we go looking for the diseased dollar bills, isn't it?
Okay, Agent, you're looking for any
wow.
bills our pal Amherst used to spread his original virus strain.
Yeah, that really is.
What's up? So with any luck, there should be plenty of contaminated greenback flying around in there.
Uses any to remember the fucking controls for this game.
Yeah, it's hard when we play so many different games.
It's also hard when you haven't played in such a long time where your character is no longer the top gear score.
Yeah. That's true, we've been playing on alternate characters and different gear scores and that.
Well, I've been playing Warframe, so...
This is true. As I said, tomorrow...
That's another game that you guys can look forward to us doing a Let's Play of.
This is true.
It's Warframe.
I'm looking forward to that a lot. I'm hoping to pick some goals in Warframe and have us do them as teams.
We could honestly set just the second dream quest line as our goal.
I'm okay
and then
with that.
Just work up towards the second dream, you know?
Completely okay with that.
And just do planet taxiing and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Or we could do it the really hard way and just do, what's it called? Do all the missions that lead up to that area
mm-hmm.
and do it the old school way.
Sounds like yeah, that would be interesting. I'll start feeding Isaac. I know that
make the quest play longer, give it a little bit more length.
This is true. I know that at the moment, the only real complaint people have with Warframe is that it doesn't seem to have much structure, and it's mostly just repetitive missions. I find I'm completely okay with that because it's beautiful to look at and fun to play.
Ow.
Yeah. And I mean, for a free game, I've seen less structure and less fun gameplay in games I spent $100 on.
Yeah, honestly. Ow, fucking son of a bitch, dude.
Warning. Emergency fire suppression system activated. System obstructed on upper floors. Manual override.
There you go.
Required.
Nice and healing.
Great. There you go.
You're
keep
welcome.
Going. I'll keep digging through these schematics and tell Isaac where the overrides are.
Hey, restock.
With 1.6 coming out, there's a lot of discussion going on all over the internet about what should be changed, and I don't know that I want a lot of changes. One of the big things in this game that doesn't work, I mean really I find doesn't work, is the idea that if you're building a high skill power support player, at the same time he's a killer, because a high skill power means that things like sticky bombs and seeker mines do ridiculous amounts of damage.
Yeah.
But that's not generally what a support type character is usually keyed to. You know, doing a lot of damage is not what your healer support should be doing. It would be something interesting, I think, to see a high skill power divided. Let's say for abilities like healing or pulse, that they definitely increase the effectiveness, whereas for abilities like Seeker Mine, Sticky Bomb, whatever, how would it be if instead of increasing the effectiveness, it just reduced the cooldown?
Yep.
You know, you'd still, you know, give it a flat damage, give Seeker Mines and Sticky Bombs, it does a percentage of the total health of your enemy in damage. It's a bomb, it explodes, it hurts.
Yeah.
Oh, look who it is, it's the jackass who started this whole shit.
Mm-hmm. Gator.
Spoilers!
I think we knew that right from
our
the word
Our viewers
go.
Haven't seen that part of the game yet. Butthole.
I thought the opening showed that.
Plus, Kendall already said that he's most likely the dude.
This yeah,
is
true.
This is true. Besides, the game's been out for a year. if you haven't figured it out by now.
Yeah, honestly. We cover the dollar bills. Oh yes, hello. I'm gonna use this here shield. I'm gonna kick the fucking piss out of all of you. Ow. Beautiful.
There we are.
All coming down the
stairs. Pulse out.
Sticky bomb! No, no target. Sticky bomb, there we go.
Yeah, I feel that at the moment, at the higher end, there isn't enough trade when you build into any specific aspect of your character, like firearms or health or whatever, or especially skill. There just isn't enough trade-off. You're not losing anything by doing it. And I know that feeds into what some YouTubers like SkillUp and that have talked about. They'd like to see a much more defined role for characters, like being able to choose classes and that. I don't know if we need to go that far. I think we're just happy enough with with a more of a penalty, anyway, for specking hardcore into one aspect.
No pressure.
Object test negative for viral contamination. Object test negative for viral contamination.
Need to get into here somehow.
Hey, sweet. Fire hazard detected.
According to the schematics, there should be an emergency override up ahead.
Contagion detected.
Bingo. That's got to be our virus-infected bills somewhere nearby. Keep an eye out, but just don't lick them.
Just don't lick them.
Warning. Fire hazard detected.
I found another manual override for the fire suppression system. Sending Isaac the location now.
I think the heartbreak of year one in the Division has been that they've spent so much time fixing the game itself, they haven't had an opportunity to advance the story in any meaningful way.
Yeah.
That would make a big difference, you know. I mean, Destiny got year one and managed to bring in storylines, raids, other things, and year two was even better. They're lucky that they have a good solid community that's willing to put up with a lot. Let's see if we can pick this guy off on the move. One of the things too I noticed watching gameplay footage from other videos is once you hit level 30, and especially into the PvP, this game stops being a cover-based shooter. I never see anybody in cover. They're just running around like five-year-olds chasing a soccer ball, just picking away at each other. I don't know if that's good or bad. I mean, I know the game is designed to be a cover-based shooter, and if you find a way to not have to do that, I suppose good for you.
It kind of loses its point.
It does lose it. It loses the point of all of those skills that are based around cover, like on the move, and I don't remember the names of every single one of them, but there are all kinds of skills in this game based around using cover effectively. You can get healing from on a cover-to-cover move, extra damage, extra stability, you know, you can have pieces of armor that make your health regen faster while you're in cover. And all of those become useless in a PvP setting if literally everyone is just running around in a big circle shooting at each other. Damn it.
Oh man, I'm almost dead. Fast
enough. Didn't get my heal off fast enough. If you can bring me up, I can get a heal on both of us.
Ah yes, much better. Yes.
Did they get too close?
Yes. After this mission, I'm gonna go take a shower and get ready and stuff.
Whoa.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, this mission took the right length.
In the back.
Very good video.
Oh, we got a yellow.
And a purple over here, purple, blue, whatever.
Yeah, John, they're right. They're right around you.
Ow, I'm downed again. They got around behind me. That's okay. I'm making my way back. Plenty of time in the bleed out. And a heal.
Yeah, no.
Agent on your team is down.
We got you, buddy. Come back to me.
Agent, but I need those bills intact and room temperature, no crispy edges. Crispy means heat, means off comes the prom dress.
And try not to get yourself killed in the process. Crispy agents aren't much use to us either.
Warning, viral contamination confirmed.
Keep your eyes peeled, Agent. We just got a report from JTF observers outside the building. More cleaners arrived while you were busy upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
Give them a wide berth. I know I've said this before, but I need those bills in mint condition, so to speak.
Warning. You are now entering a contaminated area. Exiting the contaminated area.
There's a restock here in case you guys need it.
No, I'll go for it. Okay. Where are these jerks? Let's see. I hear them.
There they are. Alright, where's the bacon?
Turret's drawing is aggro.
Nice.
Alert. Hostiles approaching. Alert. Hostiles approaching.
Oh, we got a good one on there. Get over to me, I'm right beside you.
Morning. Are you fucking agent for real right now?
Yeah, we got torched. We got caught in a corner there. See if we can move around to here. Oh, he's upstairs. That's why.
Yeah.
We're moving back to the far side.
All right. I'm behind cover.
Yeah. We're both moving behind cover. We're gonna wind up dropping, but it's not too big a deal. If you could get
hated this mission when I first did it, man. Oh my god, I hated this mission.
Fun. I'll just spectate from your point of view. If you can take down the secondary guys and just leave him,
oh yeah,
you probably have a chance to come and get one of us. Yeah, so I think the next video we'll do is the recruitment video that we've been talking about over the last few videos, and we'll do it from inside the Warframe Dojo so everyone can have a chance to see how well we've built and what it involves. I'm looking forward to whatever the last stand in this game turns out to be, whether it's a horde mode, whether it's
a large... I think it'd be really cool if it was just like a horde mode.
Yeah.
You know? Like a horde survival thing.
Interesting.
I've always loved horde modes.
I haven't seen too much info on it just
actually
yet.
No, because I don't think it'll be a horde mode. Only reason being is because we have the what's it called,
incursion. Oh yeah, Falcon Lost.
Yeah, just because that basically is a horde mode.
Mm-hmm.
10 waves of bullshittery.
15.
Yellow behind you, bud.
Yep, I saw.
Yeah, 15 waves of crazy for almost no reward. That was a drawback to making every boss in the game drop loot. Is that anything where you have to spend more than 5 minutes killing a boss becomes something that no one wants to do.
Yep.
I wouldn't be sad if after 1.6 they toned down the drop rates just a little. Just a wee little bit. Doesn't have to be, you know, back to the old 1.3 where you kill 30 bosses in a row and maybe get something worth having. But every single boss, every single time, doesn't have to drop you a top-notch piece of 256 gear.
Even for you, Justin, you're playing very conservatively.
Well, I mean, if he dies, we're stuck doing this again, so I don't mind. He's letting his turret do a lot of the work.
Yeah.
He's got two flamethrowers. Yeah, there's two. There's one behind you and one in front of you.
No, it's worse. The big guy.
Oh, over the side, man.
He's gonna get wiped.
Ah. Yeah, their range on those things is crazy. I think we probably have time to finish this last bit.
Yeah.
Depending on where it puts us.
Here's the thing.
Because after this, the mission's over.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. What I usually do, I usually trigger it downstairs, then go back upstairs.
That's not a terrible idea.
Yeah. Unfortunately, the elevator door is closed off. So we can't get back up.
Okay. We should be able to dance them around a bit. I love seeing 2,300. Yeah, I love seeing 2,300 points when I hit a guy as opposed to, you know, 500,000 in my top character. Okay, I hit one of his tanks. Nice.
Time to run.
Fall back. We've hit him a few times. See if we can take out some of his buddies so that they don't get around us too much.
I got the shieldy guy.
I've almost completely broken his armor.
What the fuck?
Okay, we'll come and get you in a sec. I'll try and draw them away.
Why'd you walk away from
him? We burned his armor
yeah,
down. He's almost dead.
Yeah, because he's coming
right
up.
I got him.
Nice.
Right in his fucking tank. Ow.
Get some cover.
I am my own cover. It reminds me of that picture of the snake where it's curled around itself and it's like, I am my own blankie. Die. Die. There we go.
As always, we will bring in a fourth from our clan if someone is available at any given time, but the three of us are going to be the four. And,
oh my god, guys, your green stuff! Hey, how about that shit of gold? Grenade to the vase!
There we go.
Ow, what the fuck was that shit? Oh my god! Oh shit, dude.
Can you get to me?
The hell just hit me?
There you are.
Oh, yes, it up.
He's a yellow, that's why.
Yeah, he hits hard.
I know, it wasn't even that. It was just he wasn't there. He was like across the map.
I'd
and
like
then I
to
spontaneously
see...
took a fuckload of damage right behind me when he wasn't there. That's the problem.
I think I'd like to see frag grenades either become significantly more useful or go away completely in favor of more,
honestly, yeah,
more crowd control style grenades. There's no use on them. Even if you put bleed on a guy, the amount of damage it does is really negligible. Locating
undamaged bills with a yay, level 10. Like looking for needles in a
haystack. Yep. But damned if you didn't pull it off. What did the boss?
I can't wait to get my hands on them. Oh, an agent?
I got green stuff, guys.
Assuming there ever is one.
Hey, I got an RPK.
Nice. I'm using an RPK now. It's quite the gun.
That I'm not gonna fucking use because it sucks compared to my shotgun.
Well, there you are. All right.
Hey, sweet. An M1911.
Ooh. That being the end of this mission, we're going to call it here. I want to thank everyone for joining us. Look forward to the next episode, which will be up as soon as we can make it, and we'll take on the next mission. We want to thank you from House Stormwing here at Fireteam Blackwatch, and we'll see you next time. Bye!
Okay, bye.
Bye.